A steam trap is used to block the flow of steam and allow only the passage of condensate. One of the most common types of steam trap is the inverted bucket type steam trap. It consists of an inlet, an outlet, a valve, and a bucket. Water and steam enters from the inlet. The level of the water is maintained above the bucket. Steam is trapped between the inverted bucket and the water. When steam fills about two-thirds of the bucket started to rise. The reason of this is going to be discussed later in the video. When the bucket rises up, it closes the valve and no fluid exits from the trap. As time passes, the steam loses its heat to the surrounding water. As a result of that, part of the steam condenses. When steam condenses, its volume decreases significantly, and the bucket loses its buoyancy. So the valve starts to open. This will allow water to exit and trap the steam. Now let's discuss why the bucket floats when it is mostly filled with steam. The top surface of the bucket is acted by the pressure of water at point 1. This pressure is less than the pressure at point 2 by the amount rho gh, as our knowledge in fluid mechanics tells us, where rho is the density of water. Now let's analyze the pressure at point 3, which acts on the top surface of the bucket like point 1, but pressure at point 1 tries to move the bucket down, while pressure at point 3 tries to raise the bucket up. Pressure at point 3 will be smaller than pressure at point 2, but with a tiny amount, because the difference again is rho gh. But this time, rho is the density of steam, which is much less than the density of water. The resultant force of these two pressures will create a force that acts in the direction upward, depends on the amount of steam in the bucket. Keep in mind that the bucket has a weight that tries to move it downward. When the amount of steam is sufficient enough, there will be an upward force larger than the gravity, which will move the bucket up. One last thing is a small hole inside the bucket. Now, this is used to relieve the non-condensable gases. One important question: what about the steam that escapes from this hole? The answer is that this amount of steam is so small that will instantly condenses as it escapes. Thanks for watching.